I'm told that one of the joys of cross-country skiing is that the basics are very simple to learn. So here goes. Julie, where do we start?
Yes, we stay on both skis. We bend your knees and then your poles bring in this position and then we slide like on the road.
Just as though we're walking on the road, is it?
Yes, that's right.
So far, so good.
Even after your first lesson, you can practice safely by yourself, but it's worthwhile taking further instruction to improve your technique. Three half-day lessons, for instance, cost about £22.
Oh. I thought I was doing quite well there.
Langlauf is strenuous, but you can go at your own pace. It's actually much easier than walking in the snow. That's not so surprising, since it was first used by the Scandinavians as a practical way of getting about, long before downhill skiing was invented. Kandersteg has around 50 miles of well-maintained and varied cross-country tracks, mostly at resort level, but two circuits are higher up in the mountains. Even so, unlike downhill skiing, it's not worth buying a lift pass, another saving. With some experience, you can tackle the vast snowfields of Sundbul. You may be off the main tourist trails up here, but you're still on the beaten track. Your guidelines ensure you won't get lost or suddenly plunge down unexpected steep slopes. Whichever direction you head, you're never far from refreshment.
This helps keep the cold out. It's Café Fertig and it's strong coffee, well laced with local schnapps. Switzerland has a reputation both for high standards and high prices. So just how expensive is it?
At the current exchange rate of 2.30 francs to the pound, you'll pay about £1.20 for a beer, a little less for a cup of coffee, around £1.75 for a bowl of soup, while the dish of the day averages £5.50. If you prefer to make your own holiday arrangements, you can travel by train. The Kandersteg is on the main European rail network. In addition, Dan Air operates 5 winter flights a week between Gatwick and Bern. The current apex return fare is £99. You have to pay 14 days in advance and stay at least one Saturday night. In little more than an hour after arriving in Bern, you could be on the ski slopes.
Langlauf is taking a long time to catch on with the British, although I suppose things might have changed in the last few days. It's not as exhilarating as downhill skiing, but it has big advantages. I mean, you can get out and about on skis quickly and safely. And it's so peaceful and quiet, and you've plenty of time to enjoy the beautiful scenery. Mind you, first couple of days you're a bit stiff. I found parts of my body I didn't know I had. Great fun, though.